Honorable Chief Guest, Mr. S.K. Vashes, IAS Joint Secretary, Sugar and Administration, Department of Food and Public Distribution, Ministry of Consumer Affairs, Food and Public Distribution, Government of India. Mr. Vimal Kumar Dubey, IAS and Managing Director of UP Cooperative Sugar Federation. Madam IAS from Tamil Nadu. Mr. Naik Navre, Mr. Jaiswal, Mr. Kailash Ji, Narendra Mohan Sahab, and all distinguished people on the dais and off the dais. I also welcome council members, members of association, and ladies and gentlemen. Good morning to all of you, and thanks for patiently waiting. We were delayed by more than 20 minutes. So my apology on that part. Once again, I welcome you in the city of Indore, heart of India, Madhya Pradesh, cleanest city continuously twice. And we are really enjoying the hospitality here. On behalf of Sugar Technologists, which is association formed in 1925, this is an association which is a knowledge-based platform wherein all sugar industry as well as machinery manufacturers and allied industries related to sugar annually meet and discuss about what latest has happened, what new research they have done, what good thing they have achieved in their factory, and that is a take home for the rest of the delegates here. We continuously to do so, and also this is the time to recognize the good work which is done by our people, our seniors, our colleagues in this industry, and we recognize them by awarding here in this particular annual convention. We are doing the same this time also. There are a lot of papers, research papers, around about 60, 62, wherein I request you to be more and more interactive and discuss and take home what good is being done by our colleagues. We all know that sugar production this year, we generally used to say that India is the second largest sugar producer, but that's no more the case. This year we surpassed the Brazil, and next year also we are going to be more than Brazil. So, but the best part that whenever I have seen in my more than 3 decades of experience, that whenever the sugar production is bumper and more, the government was not proactive in past to give help to the industry. Because of that, sugar prices generally slumped to, you know, 22, 23 rupees per kg. And factories were not in position to give back the arrears. There is huge arrears in the past for the farmers. But this year, government has acted very swiftly. As soon as the forecast came out of the sugar production, there are a lot of subsidies has been offered. There has been a lot of soft loans which has been offered. And all sugar organizations, institutes, and as well as government machinery has worked together and find out a good solution wherein government has announced that 29 rupees will be the minimum sugar price. There will be a package for the setting up ethanol and JLD facilities. New biofuel policy has been declared in which you can make ethanol also direct and B heavy also. From B heavy to ethanol, a special price has been given, which is around about 4 rupees more than the normal ethanol. And because of that, if we calculate the break even, because roughly, we are going to have 1.5% less recovery, because if you divert B heavy and don't make C mascot, C sugar, But at the same time, if you compare with the price which has been offered by the government, that 1.5% break evens at around 38, 39 rupees per kg. So that means until sugar goes beyond 40 or around 40, it's wise move to go on the heavy route to make ethanol. And if we make ethanol from B-heavy, sugar quality is going to improve, your steam consumption is going to be less, your plant efficiencies will be better, probably little more throughput you can take from your sugar plant. And your distillery will be in a better position to give a better efficiency on B-heavy and slightly higher production from the same capacity. So all in all, this is a win-win situation. And we are looking forward at STAI platform. I strongly advocate that most of the factories should do B-heavy route so that we have less sugar. If hypothetically, if everybody does that, then we are going to have 15% less sugar. We are expecting 35 million tons of sugar next year. Then 15% means we are talking about more than 5 million tons of sugar less. And government already given a support on export, which is about 2 million tons, and then there is a buffer of 4 million tons. So put these all things put together, the sentiment seems to be very favorable, and it will be more favorable if we all go for B-heavy routes, and we have a lot of industry stalwarts here, we have owners here, we have policy makers here. So again, I urge that B-heavy is a recommended route this year, at least. Friends, one more thing which we are in this industry facing at this moment, which I strongly want to say, is laboratories. Second is environment. We have to be very careful on the quality of laboratories, the kind of testings which we do. Because if we are able to have a very high precision laboratories, we will be able to extract more sugar which is coming in the cane, and we will be able to adopt more technologies instead of on gut feel, better on a... Because in old times, Hakims used to see the nubs and they used to give medicines, but now nobody takes that way. We all go to the pathology and gets tested, precise, and those numbers decides what medicine we will have. So probably this is a time for industry also to have more precise testing. As far as environment is concerned, we all know there are towns, cities, which are depleting water, and India is no more exception in this also. And sugar being having a lot of surplus water, we can use judiciously, make our factories zero liquid discharge, and can have potable water also from there by putting good RO plants. Now, because I won't take much time, already we are late, running late in this program. I want to touch upon the good work which is being done by our senior people. So we are going to have few lifetime achievement awards this year. And then we are having Industry Excellence Award, and we have NRI Award, which we give every year. And I'm glad that we are having among us Mr. Kaushik Pabari, who is one of the richest person in Kenya and has put up a most modern sugar plant, probably in one of the most modern in Africa and Kenya, producing 3,500 tons of sugarcane crushing and 18 megawatt cogeneration plant. So we recognize his contribution, and he is among us. Then Mr. Mamre for his contribution to boiler, Mr. Prakash Naik Navre for relentlessly working for Indian sugar industry, Mr. Shankar Narayanan for his world known consultancy in boiler, sugar, ethanol, Mr. Jain, one of the very old sugar technologists, and quite a lot he contributed. Mr. K.K. Kohli, a stalwart in sugar industry, who has, you know, did lot of process conversion from carbonation to sulfitation and made sulfitation process more popular in those times. In industry excellence, we have Mr. Vivek Maheshwari, who is really taking flag high for with Kailash ji and other his colleagues in MP and MP Sugar, which was not very vibrant, say about 10-15 years back. We are proud that MP Sugar is picking up. Mr. Tamak Saab, who have turned around Olam and then now he is in DSCL, he is contributing not only in sugarcane but the growth of the factory and complex facilities. Mr. Saroha, Mansi Agarwal, and our Honorable Minister from Maharashtra State, Mr. Atul Bhosle, a young leader who is running 3 sugar mills in Maharashtra, which are having highest efficiencies and one of the highest recoveries over there. So we salute him. We congratulate all award winners, and we also wish you a grand success this STAI convention. For ladies, I will definitely say that a lot of mythological places are near, a lot of good temples are here, Jyotirlingas are here, and then I have heard a lot of good shopping areas also. So you will also have fun. We wish you all a grand success of this convention. Please interact and take back good out of these 3 days. Thank you very much. Jai Hind, Jai Bharat.